there is a threat to Hinduism. Muslim men under conspiracy are trying to lure Hindu women into love jihad. A stringent law is required to tackle it. These were the arguments that were put forward while tabling the law against religious conversion act that was enacted in Uttar Pradesh in 2020. Last 1 year's data will shed some light on whether the law was envisaged to check a crime or harass a particular community. According to the data accessed from the UP police, a total of 108 cases under the new anti-conversion law were registered in the state between November 2020 to August 2021. No one has yet been convicted in any of these cases, and most of them are either in the investigation stage or pending in court. Let's get into the details. A total of 257 suspects were booked and 83 names came up during the investigation in the 108 cases registered across the state. According to the data, 56 suspects were wrongly named in these cases. 31 of the total cases relate to suspects being minor. Charge sheet has been produced in 72 of these cases, and investigation is pending in 24, while there are 11 such cases where police filed closure report after it could not find evidence against the suspects in the investigation. Under the new Anti-Conversion Act, a maximum of 28 cases were registered in Bareilly zone, followed by 25 in Meerut zone. No case under the new law was registered in Varanasi Commissionerate. The bottom line is, for two people in love, they, along with the families, have to undergo mental and physical harassment and are being punished without any charges being proved against them in the court of law. Keeping their families, career and relationship aside, they are drawn into legal battles with the state, where eventually the process becomes the punishment. Apart from the legal battle, they have to keep up with the parallel fight with right-wing organizations, the alleged custodians of Hinduism, who harass them in public, thrash them in court and at police stations, with cops acting as silent spectators. Several states began emulating UP after anti-conversion law came into force. But the way this law has been used in UP raises serious concerns over intentions of the government.